गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम आई विल कंटिन्यू विद द प्रीवियस चैप्टर, दैट इज लाइफ प्रोसेस. सो दिस इज द लास्ट लाइफ प्रोसेस विच वी विल डिस्कस टूडे, एंड आफ्टर दैट विल फिनिश अ चैप्टर. एक्सक्रीशन, आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू दिस इन द लास्ट पोर्शन ऑल्सो. आई हैव गिवन यू द इंट्रोडक्शन, सो आई वुड लाइक टू रिवाइज इट. फर्स्ट, The what is excretion, children? The removal of waste material from the body of living organisms is called excretion. These waste materials, it can be toxic to living organisms. In plants, excretion of waste gases takes place during respiration and photosynthesis. How? Through the stomata. And students, you have got the slides also, so you can, while hearing the audio, you can see the slides also, so that you have a better understanding. Children, it happens in all the living organisms. Excretion takes place in all the living organisms, but the methods used is different. Okay, now in humans, generally there are two types of waste. The one is the respiratory waste, which is produced during respiration. The waste which is produced during respiration is what? Carbon dioxide, water, energy. Water is used up by the body, water is used by the body. Energy is also stored in the form of ATP. But carbon dioxide is a waste gas and which needs to be removed, and it is removed through lungs. And nitrogenous wastes. Nitrogenous waste is produced due to the breakdown of proteins, and it is removed by excretory system. Now children, as I told you, like all the living organisms, this is excretion is the characteristic property of all the living organisms. And the method used is different for different living organisms. In unicellular organisms like amoeba, paramecium, the wastes are removed by simple diffusion, okay, through the cell membrane or the plasma membrane. Now, the nitrogenous waste that is removed by the excretory system, that is the kidneys. Okay, now kidneys are present in the abdomen on either side of the backbone. Okay, and the excretory system, it consists of kidneys, ureters and the urethra. And kidneys are present where? In the abdomen region on either side of the backbone. And they are bean shaped. Then the urine is formed by the kidneys. In the kidneys only the urine is formed. And with the kidneys, there are fine tubes called ureters. The ureters, they carry the urine, okay, in the urinary bladder. And in the urinary bladder, it is stored. So this I have actually already discussed with you in the previous class. Now today we will discuss how the urine is formed in the kidneys. Okay, children, these kidneys, okay, they have large number of units, small units, more than millions of small units, which are called as nephrons. You can see in the image also. Okay, so large number of nephrons are there, and the urine is produced in these nephrons only. Now just see the structure of nephron in the slide. Nephron, it consists of a cup shaped structure. Nephron consists of cup shaped structure, which is called as Bowman's capsule. Okay, and with the cup shaped structure, there is a U shaped tube. See nicely in the image. First, there is a cup-shaped structure which is called as Bowman's capsule, and with it is attached one U-shaped tube which is called as a tubule. Now, students, I told you before, aorta, it leaves the heart from the left ventricle and it divides into many arteries. And arteries go into different organs and they provide oxygen to the cells. And the exchange of gases takes place. The blood in the artery, it becomes deoxygenated. And what happens? The artery first divides into capillaries. Then the exchange of gases takes place. And the blood in the capillaries, it becomes deoxygenated and then the capillaries they join to form veins, and the blood, the deoxygenated blood, is carried by these veins. So I told you this before. So there is an artery which is named as renal artery. Renal means anything related to kidney. Pulmonary means anything related to lungs. So the name of this artery, renal artery, means what? This artery, renal artery, it brings the blood. Now I told you what the difference between deoxygenated and oxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood is what? Which contains more of carbon dioxide and less of oxygen, but it will contain food particles, it will contain waste particles, it will contain other things. Only difference is that here the oxygen will be less and the carbon dioxide will be more. In oxygenated blood also, oxygen will be more, carbon dioxide will be less, but it will also contain waste, it will also contain food. So this renal artery, it comes in the Bowman's capsule, and here it breaks into large number of fine blood vessels which are called as capillaries. Okay, and this network of these capillaries are thin walled, and the network of these capillaries is called as glomerulus. You can see in the slide, the network of capillaries is called glomerulus. Bowman's capsule is the cup shaped structure, and in that is the glomerulus. Now children, glomerulus, I told you, the glomerulus is nothing but the walls, network of capillaries. Now the blood which comes in the capillaries, okay, it will be oxygenated, but it will have waste material also, nitrogenous waste it will have food also, it will have some salts also. So the walls of the capillaries is so thin that nitrogenous waste, water, glucose, amino acids and minerals, they pass through the capillaries walls into the Bowman's capsule. And just remember, the water also passes in the Bowman's capsule. And with the Bowman's capsule, what is attached? Tubule is attached. Okay, now these capillaries, I told you, they all will join and they will form what? One vein. So same thing happens here also. The renal artery divides into capillaries, and these capillaries they join to form vein, which is also called as renal vein. And this renal vein, it coils round the tubule. You will see some blue color thing coiling round the tubule, and it is thinner than the tubule. So actually these things have filtered from the glomerulus, that is the capillary network, into the Bowman's capsule, and from the Bowman's capsule it passes through the tubule. Tubule is U-shaped. When it passes through the tubule, okay, as it passes through the tubule, just at the beginning of the tubule, all the important things like amino acids, glucose, certain minerals, okay, they are reabsorbed by the blood flowing in the capillaries, because I told you the capillaries, they form a network around the tubule. And now because the pressure in the glomerulus is so much that, and the walls are thin, that these substances, they filter, they go into the Bowman's capsule. From the Bowman's capsule, they will be in the form of a solution, because water is also there. They will go down. And at the upper end of the U-tubule, okay, these things, the important things like glucose, amino acids, minerals and water, is reabsorbed by the blood flowing in the renal vein. Because renal vein is forming a, it's coiling around the tubule. Okay, now In the tubule, there will be more of nitrogenous waste and water. So that will pass down to the tubule. When it will reach to the U structure of the tubule down, again reabsorption takes place. Okay. Again, the water, the amino acid, the glucose, minerals are again reabsorbed. And the only thing now left in the U tubule, at the lower side, is water and the nitrogenous waste, and it forms the urine. And this forms the urine. Now this urine goes and collects in the collecting duct. In the collecting duct, other nephrons also open and they also pass their urine. Now the collecting duct joins, rejoins and opens into the ureters. Understood, children? Now, okay, so this is how the urine is formed. And that renal vein, Okay, now in that renal vein, blood is there. So all the important things will be reabsorbed in the blood, and then that renal blood will come out of the kidney. Okay, it will be, the blood will be blue in color, because it will have more of carbon dioxide and less of oxygen. You can see in the image. And I told you the veins, they come out of the organ. So same way here, the renal vein will come out. Okay, because side by side exchange of gases will also take place. Okay, from the cells, the carbon dioxide will go into the blood, flowing in the renal vein, and oxygen will go into the cells for, okay. So, all the processes takes place together. So, here the exchange of gases will also take place, and this thing will also take place. So, because of exchange of gases, the blood in the renal vein will be blue. It will be deoxygenated blood, but it will have all the, it will carry all the important food materials. And then the blood will leave the organ, that is the kidney, and then it will join with other veins. Other veins will join with other veins, and then it will open in the right auricle. Okay. I hope all of you have understood. Now children, what is ultrafiltration? Now I told you, in the capillaries, in the walls are very thin and the pressure is more of the blood. All the things like the small particles like aminoacids, glucose, waters, urea, uric acid, nitrogenous waste, they all comes in the tubule. This is called as ultra, this process is called as ultrafication. And all these things are called as ultrafiltrate. I hope all of you have understood this thing. Excretion, okay. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Now children, sometimes what happens, some disease, maybe some kidneys gets damaged or something happens. So in that case, what happens, in the extreme case, the kidneys are transplanted, okay. Initially the person is put on dialysis. In your book, that short portion is given, did you know, just go through it, okay, just go through it, and if you have any doubt, you can clarify the doubts. If you have any doubt regarding excretion, you can clarify in the evening session. Now I have given you the solution of previous chapters I have given you assignments, so I have given you all the solutions and question answers already we have done. So I would like to give you a few questions of exercises of acid, bases and salts. Okay, so those questions I have given in the assignment. Okay, here in the slide only, in the document only, down you will see certain questions are written, some questions are written, so those questions you have to do on your own. Okay, so I hope you have understood. So with this I finish life processes. Okay, and now in the next class we will start up with nervous system. Thank you students. As so after, just after hearing the audio, you can continue with the question and answers. I have the question answers of the exercises, or you can revise the portion, or you, if you have any doubt, you can clear the doubt also, but you have to do the question answers after hearing the audio. Thank you students.